Goodness, so many takes. I've never done this before. If you know anything about my videos, you know that normally I do vlogs or challenges, so a chit-chat video like this isn't all that much in my comfort zone, but I'm going to try. So bear with me. Today's topic I'm going to talk about is, what's it like to be an army wife? It's kind of hard to say, especially since I'm gonna have to generalize it, even though I can only speak from my experiences. So if you can somewhat relate, leave a comment, press a like, you know, whatever you feel. But for me, being an army wife is difficult. It isn't the ideal marriage that you would expect, that you see on TV or anything like that. It's extremely hard on both parties. To be an army wife, or when I say army, kind of think of it as military in general. However, each branch has their own customs and how they handle things when it comes to the family life. Army in particular, they are not family oriented. It makes it extremely hard, but it's what I signed up for, so I can't really complain about it. So these are a few things that I have learned, and I hope, truly hope, that helps somebody out there who is either considering marrying into the military lifestyle and doesn't go on to blame their spouse for the lifestyle, because it is a lifestyle that you are personally choosing. So let's get on with this. In army life, everything will land on you. To be a wife in particular, in general, altogether, to be a wife and a mom, everything does land on you and on your shoulders. Now add in a whole army on top of that, where you want to rest, you want to do something for yourself, you want to go out and shop for 30 minutes. Next thing you know, your husband or spouse, I mean, you could be married to a woman also, but they get called in, and next thing you know, your whole plan is gone. It does not matter anymore. You will come second. Your family, unfortunately, even though in your eyes, your family and yourself and everything that you're trying to put together comes first, unfortunately, your spouse has no choice but to oblige and but to follow through and show up for their career. And you can't be upset, and I say this because I am known within my family, especially with my husband, and I feel so bad for him. I get upset. I get extremely upset because the branch that I was in prior was the Coast Guard, and they're extremely family oriented. But I can't, it's hard for me not to compare and contrast, but I really have to. And any wife out there who is married to a soldier can attest that it is extremely hard. If you have a dog, it's extremely hard, because everything, vet visits, walking, park visits, anything lands on you. Same with if you are your mother. Now, if you're just simply a wife, it isn't simple. You still have house chores. And if you have your own career path, goodness, that's a whole other thing that you have to add on to. Me personally, I am a very independent person. I'm till this day finding it extremely hard to, to rely so much, if not completely, on Alex. It's extremely hard. I have to. Because he and I, when I was pregnant with Mateo, he and I agreed that the best thing would be for me to stay home and kind of pause everything for myself, for Mateo's safety, because we just don't feel comfortable letting just a stranger into our lives and close to our son, especially with the things that we've been seeing in the news. So we just said, you know what, Alex can provide for the whole entire family for the time being until Mateo is old enough to speak on his behalf and on his own and tell us whether or not they're treating him correctly. If you are marrying into the army and have no background in the military, you may find it difficult, especially with the moves, because you're not gonna know anybody. You're not gonna know the place. You're not gonna know the area. You're literally at a loss. On a regular basis, you are completely lost and on your own, which granted, you always hear, oh, you're military, we support you. You're a military wife. Thank you for caring for our soldier. Thank you, but we don't know anybody. And in this society, nobody really talks to one another, so it makes it extremely hard for us to feel any sort of comfort, because all we're doing is following our spouse. We don't know how to handle everything, yet everything gets thrown at us to handle. So if you're marrying into the military, goodness, I give you props, because that's hard. I luckily have prior experience, so I knew already what I was signing up for, but it is going to be extremely hard, and you have to be very strong to really just take a step back and say, all right, this is what's gonna happen. I may not see my family for months, if not years, unless they come to me, because military personnel, they don't make that much either. So it's extremely difficult for the spouse, the civilian spouse, to travel to see anybody else. And yet we're relying so much on our husbands or our spouses. Now, for those of you who don't have children, you may have pets, and you know, pets, for me, pets are just as hard. Now, if you yourself are still currently working while being married to a soldier, that makes it 10 times harder, because you most likely are having difficulties seeing each other with the training that they have to do, the last minute calls that they have to come in for, the fact that they can do, depending on what schedule they have, the schedule can be freaking a regular 9 to 5. It could be midnight sessions, it could be midday sessions, it could be random, hey, come in for 2 hours, you have to leave again for another 3 hours, then come back again for another 2 hours. It's extremely difficult to keep up with all of that. And for those of you, and it is very possible for them to be on for 2 days, off for 3 days, on for 2 days, off for 3 days. And when I say that, I mean full-on 24-hour sessions where you do not see your spouse for maybe 48 hours complete until they come home. And then they're exhausted. And even though you're like, finally, I get a break, because my husband, for me, I'm gonna say husband, my husband's finally home. I can get a break, I can take a breather, but they're tired too. And then that's when it hits you. You never really get a break. You no longer matter as much. And as hard as it is even for me to say out loud, because it's something that I'm still struggling to accept, it's what I signed up for. And if my husband isn't feeling good, then he can't do his soldierly duties. If he does not do his soldierly duties, he can get in trouble for it. And if he gets in trouble so many times, then he can get court-martialed. if he gets court-martialed, there's a chance he loses his job completely. And I know this because of my past too. So not only does the house rely on me to keep it going, but my husband relies on me to keep him going. And if he's not going, then we all drop. So if you are an army wife, you have to learn to put everyone and everything first. And if you are not ready to do that, you might not be ready to be an army wife. Because at the very end of the day, your whole family, or your husband, your life at that point will rely on them being able to do their job. It's difficult. It will take a toll. And you will have times where you are so down. It will take a huge toll on your relationship. And I'm saying that right now because it's taken a toll on us. It's difficult. And that's coming from somebody who even has prior experience being in the military herself. For those of you who don't have any knowledge of it, I can't even imagine how hard it is for you. But just know that you're not alone. A lot of us would like to be friends, even though a lot of us are introverts, because of the fact that we do move around so much. You know, naturally being put in a place that you don't recognize with people you don't know, it naturally makes you an introvert. Now, that being said, it's being an army wife makes you proud. Being an army wife is an honor. You know, it's lonesome. If you're it's hard, and that's I wish I had a lot of more positive things to say about it, but at the end of the day, I'm just trying to be honest. I'm not trying to sugarcoat anything. It's hard, and if you are not ready to be on your own most of the time, if you're not ready to handle everything on your own most of the time, if you are not ready to be by yourself and do things on your own, even though you're married, it may seem or feel like you are on your own, then you just may not be ready to step into that role. And I'm just letting you guys know now, you know, just take a breather. It's one day at a time. That's all I really gotta say. I mean, it is extremely, extremely hard. But I'm proud of all you ladies and gentlemen out there who are army wives or army husbands also, because everything at the end of the day falls on us, which then trickle down to the soldier themselves. And if we're not handling things, then they can't handle anything. So we are the silent soldiers in the background that most people tend to forget. But I'm proud of you guys. I'm proud of myself for staying sane, somewhat. And that's all I gotta say. Being an army spouse is extremely hard. And I got this. And that's all I gotta keep telling myself is I got this. That's all you guys gotta keep telling yourselves. I hope you guys have a wonderful day. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please press the like button, leave a comment, especially if you can relate to me. And yeah, just share my video. I'm trying to keep this channel going. not for money reasons at all. It's literally because, like I said, I'm an army wife. There's not much for me to do. So kind of support me, you know, because, well, I have nothing else to do. So I guess, even if you don't have, if I don't have many viewers, I'm still going to be making these videos. So hope you guys enjoy the video and have a good day.